code injection attack. Imagine being able to inject your own code into a website, allowing you to get remote control of the entire server. It's one of the most powerful methods to take over a vulnerable system, especially if you are familiar with the backend programming language. So, what are we going to do today? First, we will hit PortSwigger Lab, where I will show you how to inject your own code to run a simple OS command. Then we will dive into a BWAP Lab, where we're going to escalate our attack to inject a code that gives us a full control of the server. To make things even smoother, we're going to use a tool that automates the process of code injection attack. This is going to be so cool. So, this is AmrSec, Google Cybersecurity, and let's dive in. So what is exactly code injection attack? Let's break it down. Imagine you are on a website like that and you find an input field. It can be a search bar, a form, anything where you can enter your data. That's your entry point. Now before you get excited and start entering random things, you first need to figure out what is the back end. What is the programming language is the website running on? It could be PHP, Node.js, or even Python. Once you know that, you can execute commands directly to the server. So what is the result? You can get access to the server operating system, allowing you to run commands like who am I, ls, or even more powerful ones like opening a reverse shell or remote access. This is what makes code injection such a critical vulnerability. It's not just about breaking in, it's about gaining full control of the system. All right, let's jump into our first demo in the PortSwigger Lab. So here what I'm going to do is open my browser. I already have the OS command injection lab from PortSwigger opened in my browser. It's asking you to sort this lab, execute the who am I command. And if I just click access lab, is going to give me this symbol shop right here. And if you take another look right here, you will find that the lab contains an OS command injection and the product stock checker. So let me just open any product right here, for example. And as you can see right here, there is a check stock. If I just click check stock, it's going to tell you it's still available 32 unit. So actually I have my burp suit opened right here. So let me open the proxy server. And as you can see, it's open with me. So I will just come right here and get that link. And here I will just paste it. And here, let me make the interception on and check stock right here and back again. As you can see, I got a connection or I got this request. So I will hit Control R to send it to repeater and just close the interception. And here, if you just send this request, is going to tell you that there is 32. And right here, there is a parameter that have the product ID and the parameter that have store ID. So it can be something like running a specific command. For example, let's say stock. And for example, this stock taking the first ID of the product, for example, 2, and the second ID of the store, for example, 1. And when it checks, it's giving you the units of the product that you give it the store ID and product ID too. So what if I try to run right here a simple OS command where it's going to give me a result right here? So for example, let me try who am I command, like what it says in the lab. So first, let me just remove that and add, for example, a plus. And let me just try who am I. So right here, if I just send this request, you will see it's giving you value of 94, and this is actually is a wrong value, because actually the true value is 32, and this means that it cannot process this as a command. So what if I just add right here and this have to let him know that this is other command, and if I just send that, it told me that it's 32, and 32 is the true value, so right here it's true, but actually it did not executed this command. So this could be because right here we have another value that it will provide it to the command. So what if I just right here comment this line, so the command will be like stock 2 and who am I, and just that, there is nothing more. And let me just send that and it's the same. What if I just try to URL encode that and send? Okay, let me just remove that plus, and here plus two and another plus, and send that. And as you can see, it's told you that the user is Peter, and of course like that it have executed the whole MI command. And let me just change it by writing ls and here send. And as you can see, here is the stock report.sh, the file that checks the stock. And like that, I think is going to tell me that I have solved the lab. So right now we know who's running this server. It might not seem like much, but this information is critical. It helps us to understand our position on the server and what we can do next. Now, because PortSwigger has some limitations, we cannot run advanced commands like opening a Netcat session, but that's fine. We will cover that in the next demo. Now let's take things up a notch. We are moving to the BWAP lab, and this is where things get interesting. In this lab, we are performing a code injection attack that gives us full control of the machine. And of course, we will be using a tool called Comix as a part for automating the process. Let's get into it. So right here, I have BWAP app set up on my machine. And let me first tell you how to install Comix. If you want to install Comix, what you have to do is simply go to Google and search for Comix GitHub. And this will be the first result with you. And just scroll down a little bit, you will find the installation commands right here. Let me install it with you right here. Let me just open my terminal. Let me go to, and here simply we're going to paste this command and hit enter. And of course, it's cloning the repository right now with us. And let me just go to Comix right here. After that, what we're going to do is write in Python 3 comix.py and hit enter. And of course, let me just add dash h right here. And as you can see, the tool is installed with us and ready to go. So let me close that right here and this too, and back again to this lab right here. In the BWAP lab, specifically in the PHP command injection. So right now you have the website, but you don't know what is the programming language of the backend. So there is too much ways to know what is the backend programming language of this website. But actually, if you just have vulnerabilities extension in your browser and you click on it, let me reload it again, and it's actually working right here. And as you can see, the programming language is PHP. And here it's telling you this is just a test page reflecting back your message. And as you can see, when you click on message, it's just giving you the same thing. But if you take a look on the URL right here, you can see that where the message equal test. So let me try to do something right here, for example, hello world, and hit enter. And as you can see, it's the same, it did not change it. So what if I try to inject code right here, a PHP code that runs a specific thing I need? For example, let me just try to hit enter right here. It's not showing anything. This is a little weird. Let me change this to numbers. Okay, it's shown right now. I think this problem on my machine, but never mind. Let me just use it as a numbers right here. Whatever I just tried is going to print it as a message right here, for example, like that. As you can see, it's printing whatever I write. Okay, so right here, what if we just add a semicolon? And actually this semicolon, after that we have to run something, you know, because actually this is PHP. So let me just write here PHP info, and this will have to print the PHP info of this server. And let me just open and close bracket. And as you can see right here, we have all the PHP info. And first we have 8.0.30, the PHP version. And as you can see right here, we have all the information about the machine, or you can say the machine that PHP runs on. For example, here it's telling you it's Kali Linux, and here is the configuration. You can see that it's Apache 2.4. And let me just scroll down a little bit. We have here the HTTP headers, and of course all of this are really important info. And right here it's giving you all the information you need. For example, if I want to search for the session right here, it's going to give you all the session details. And of course this is PHP info, so if you know what is that, you will know how you can get a juicy information from that. But let me just make this a little bit cool. For example, okay, this is PHP info, so what after that? So if you can just show the PHP info or run the PHP info function, That means you can still run function like system function. And system function in the BTP, it's actually running a remote OS command on the server or the machine by itself. So let me just write here system and open bracket and just open a double quotation. Let me, for example, type ls-lah and close the double quotation and close the bracket and hit enter. And as you can see right here, it's just printed all the data in this directory, and whatever command you run here, it will be executed. For example, let me just write bwd, and this will show us where we are in this machine. And as you can see, we are in the OBT lamp, of course, htdocs, BWAP. This is cool, and I know what is your mind, and yes, we're going to do the same. We will use Netcat to get a reverse shell from this website. Right here, let me just clear this screen and run Netcat. First, let me see what is my IP. IP config, okay, IPA. And here is my IP. I think this is my IP. And here we're going to run Netcat and let it listen on the port 4444. So netcat-mlvd. And for example, let's make it 9001 or whatever port you need. And right now the machine is listening on this port. And here we're going to add a simple command that gives us a reverse shell. And like that, you will have the command that will try to connect to my machine using the port, 9001. And of course, it's going to give it a shell with bash shell, okay? So if you don't know what is actually this, it's simply running Netcat, and it's asking Netcat to connect to this IP. It's our IP, and it's asking it to connect on this port. So when it's connected, it's going to give me bin bash terminals. So if you are not familiar with the reverse shell, you can just check repshells.com. It have a lot of ways to do it, but actually for this one, I will be leaving the article down in the description where you can find how to install Comix and all the process step by step. But right here, let me just run that. And if I go to my terminal right here, and as you can see, it's telling you it's have been connected to this from this IP. And I think this IP is our machine. Let me just write ls. And as you can see right now, I'm in the machine. Let me zoom for you right here. And what if I just, for example, clear my screen? Okay, and bwd right here, we have the directory. Let me just ls that. Who am I? Not like that, come on man. Okay, who am I? Okay, no problem. And right here, let me just ls, and what if ls-lah. So here we have a lot of files, and of course all of these files are already in the same directory I'm in. So what if I just cd like that, ls, and as you can see, I can see all the files in the htdocs directory. And of course you have all the machines, so let me just stop that right here, because actually we already got it. So what if we want to automate all this process, you know, like that? Of course we have Comix, and Comix will help us to do all of that one time. First, let me grab my URL right here, and let me open my cookie right here. And as you can see, I have already a cookie on this website, and of course it's a PHP SSID right here, and we have the security level. So what I'm going to do is go into my terminal, writing python 3 comix.py, and here what I have that actually is python 3 comix.py. That means I'm just running the tool, and here I have added this tag, and this tag is allowing me to give the tool the target URL. And for the target URL right here, we have a little problem because this is just HTTP protocol, but here I have added my URL with the parameter that already vulnerable with the OS command injection, and I have just give it something like ls, and I still have problem in this command too. So here we have to do this, and of course this is pretty much it for the URL tag. And here I have give it the cookie. I give it my cookie right here. As you can see, I have PHP SSID, and I have the security level. So what I did is just provide the tool my PHP session right here, and my security level or this cookie. And what I have to do is simply just hit enter, and it's going just to load with you a little bit and give you a shell directly. And because I already have a misconfiguration, or you can say a lot of problems in my lab, specifically BWAP, and here is telling you that the tool got 302 redirect state code. So do you want to follow that? I will let him know. I don't want to follow that and enter. Of course, you will not see all of that in your site. It will be just loading, and after that, it's going to give you a shell. And here is telling you what you want to use for writable directory. Let me just go to opt, and I think right here I have it like that. Okay, whatever. And here is telling you, do you want the output in this file? Of course, I will then just no. And again, yes, anything. And as you can see, it did not work with me, because I have told you that I have misconfiguration. And as you can see, we have did all. It will work with you, trust me. But just try it. And that's actually it for today. And that's it for today's video. We have gone through two labs. First, in PortSwigger, where we kept things simple with the whole MI command. And then we ramped it up with the BWAP lab, where we used Comix and Netcat to get full remote control of the machine. If you found this video helpful, do not forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon for more cybersecurity content. And if you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments below, or you can just reach me directly using Twitter. And until next time, stay curious and stay secure. I think the girls with the nails done now.